That's the pop out check. Okay. Awesome. You know, it'd be nice if the chat ninja could just go away. Awesome. A crazy, crazy day. Mondays suck my balls. How's this sounding? Crazy, crazy day. Mondays suck my balls. Okay. So yeah, my original plan was the best. You know, from a couple of weeks ago, is you know, come home from the day job, get a nap, have some dinner, get a nap, and go from there. This was my original idea, and I deviated from it. I started excited to stream, but I'm a little loud when I stream, you know, a little boisterous. And disruptive. Looks good. I had to step away just for a bit. But, you know, the show must go on. 2020, things happen. And I'd cancel. And then, you know, chill out, watch the YouTube videos. And I want to, then I feel sad for not paying, not doing anything, not creating content. And this year I've had technical issues preventing that. But I've still managed. I was like, you know, the stressors hit. Take a break. Walk away. Center yourself. Perspective. Get perspective. Check the ego. Smoke 15 cigarettes. Then get back at it. Awesome. We're recording. We lost somebody. That's what happens. That's what happens. You know, but with the what can you do? What can you do? But yeah, I just refuse to be a train wreck this year. I was a little bit of a train wreck last year. Just kind of floating along. This year's all about the Sun Tzu, man. Sun Tzu, check it out. Mindfulness, you know? It's important. A lot of flickering, so we're gonna have to control S. Save the show. I really dig YouTube live format compared to Twitch. Mostly. There's some things I like more about Twitch. But like Twitch is good for gaming. But like for the art, you know, I want higher res, you know? Let's toggle the recording, because I'm anticipating a crash. Just, you know, wait, day's going. Yeah, these are the mad notes. Oh, same song twice in a row. Well, now I always use the same song. Go away, real. This thing really out of juice already? I just not pull it hard enough. My lungs weak. An indication you're on the right track with stuff is, the world seems to, you know, bust you in the genitals. You know, to be PC. I'd say nuts, but you gotta be conscious that not everybody has nuts. You know? But you get my gist. Art therapy, everybody. Connect the pieces through the shadows, Luke. All work and no play make Jack a dull boy. What the? Oh. Now the time has come. Kind of reminds me of Black Sabbath a little bit. Fucking neck cranks, man. Booberella. I'd like to listen to the music, but my neck hurts. My neck is in pain, man. I don't know why my neck is in pain because I keep tensing my shoulders. I keep going hunch. You know? It's not good to go hunch. What I need is a truck driver chair. That'd be sick. That'd be so rad. Connected to an air compressor. Someday. Someday it'll happen.
Well, that's level 2. Ooh. Shit. My fan stopped. Come on, save. You can do it. My fan should be running. It's coming, folks. See, I think my fan thinks the computer's falling asleep. I'm gonna let this save. I'm gonna open Premiere and see if we can either kick the fan on or make it crash. There we go. Thank you. Ooh, Barella. Don't tell me what a brush is, you jerk face. Yeah, I don't like the purple on the nose. Do your thing. I know. I light up here. Oh, I got in trouble for that video. I call it NyQuil induced. I give folks that NyQuil didn't appreciate it. I was having a fever dream. And I painted that.
The sounds of silence.
I'm in silence right now. You guys can hear stuff though. Sometimes.
Ooh, yeah. Looking good.
My stomach is making the same sounds as my computer. Beep, beep, beep.
Alright, things done did this week. Sometime middle of July 2014. Yep, I got a new toy. Been trying to figure out, playing around with that a little bit, and then I got some Jezo too, so I went Jezo crazy. I'm like, I'm gonna Jezo everything, turn it into a canvas, Jezo this log. No, I'm actually building an outside work area, outside paint area. Hey, puppy, how's it going? Oh, there's no puppies down here. What do you guys say about it? Boof. Yeah, that's right. Then I made a new desk area, new painting area for a new toy. I think I just overheated the compressor, though. So I got to sit and wait for that. I just got to do more stuff for this video, but I guess it's got to cool down. I left it on. We'll see if I could get it fired back up later. Then this, I'm trying to go for like a cherry wood look. Because I did that before with this cigar holster. But with the new paints, it was difficult to mimic the color that I had before. But this is for me. This is for my workstation. And that's what it's going to look like. So, you know, it's really just got to appeal to me. So it is what it is. I wasn't going to re-jezzo and repaint it again. I did mess up one time. Had to re-jesso it, so I got impatient. But yep, just wanted to break out the new toy, see what she can do. Then on the backside, I went like this is the side the neighbors see. I want it to look like just a nasty old board. People walking by, they'd be like, but for me, it looks pretty. Everybody else. It looks like dog dung. And yep, well, I definitely had to try it out with the space painting. So I wanted to try to render a real nice looking planet and then take it outside and do what I do. That I used acrylics, a little bit of airbrush, and took it outside for the spray cans. Just a trial run, not a serious piece. Just wanted to see if I could get something to look like Jupiter. We'll be right back.
Strike zone, the batter, some runner. Oh, whoa. Save. I wonder if you heard that. That was my stomach.
I look like a zombie. Feel like a zombie. Only 10 more minutes. That may be 2.5 hours in today. I got a little bit done. Not too bad. Stage left side of the hair more. Things like that. Dress. Couch is coming together. Alright. Thank you.
Okay, what are we doing here? Let's get the snippy tool. Zoom in. We get higher res. I forgot to record this part. It's okay. Wait a second. Yeah, that's the right one. Alrighty, welcome to the ArtCast Companion. I hope you all are keeping well, doing good about yourself. And yeah, this is gonna be an interesting one, a candid one. We pretty much, you know, worked on the skull on the couch of this iconic Vampira photograph. Just working in some details. Only got in about 3 hours. It's a Monday. The day job was mentally exhausting. And yeah, I haven't been getting much sleep. And that's because it's January. It seems like I've done videos on this in the past, time vampires, which seems pretty fitting. I think subconsciously I knew the time vampires were coming, and sure enough they did. I didn't know in the frontal lobe. I forgot about it. January's the time for time vampires, and that's when the universe throws all these things in the way of what you want to do. You know, bad batteries, bad tires, having to work extra hours overtime, which is good. That means payday. We'll have a little bit of buffer, you know, and get caught up on bills, things like that. But whew, every January the vampires come out, and I get the feeling that's for most people too, because they're trying to get caught up from the ridiculousness that is Christmas. And when I got home today, I started and I sat down, I started a prep, and I put on a YouTube video, and it was Dark Things You Might Not Have Known About the Wizard of Oz. And so I was playing that, and then I found myself getting sucked in. The vampire put its grip on me, and I started going slack-jawed, and the head started to, you know, the eyes glaze over. Like, the intellectual blood was just getting drained from my veins. And it was like, I gotta close this tab and pull up Photoshop, because we ain't tolerating it this year. Sometimes vampires you can't control. Some of them are, you know, just things that gotta get done, you know. But others you can't. You might feel like you just need to sit and watch something silly, even though you committed earlier in your brain, in your waking hours, to, you know, do one of your projects, do something that you love, write, draw, paint. You gotta force yourself to just promise yourself 10 minutes. Prep whatever your craft is. For me, it's opening up Photoshop and OBS and everything else. And then just promise yourself 10 minutes of work, and then 10 becomes 20, becomes an hour, and that is the crucifix of the time vampires. And I didn't get as much work as I would have liked to have gotten done on this, but what can you do? At least we got in, I want to say, 2.5 hours, maybe 3. I had to take a break an hour into it. A time vampire came along, and I needed to take a few to get my bearing. you know, to center myself, because it was a very stressful day. All day. Tomorrow's gonna be stressful too, but we're just gonna put on our shield of apathy tomorrow during the daytime, and at night we shall become a vampire. I'll become your time vampire. Tomorrow night I'll be streaming somewhere, probably this again. I'm wanting to finish this. I've got exciting ideas, and I'm itching to move on to the next one, but I don't want to leave this one hanging like so many other projects. So, you know, meditate, zen, discipline, and we'll do it. Outside of that, you know where to find me, BamVFX.com. I have a Patreon doing a giveaway this month. Probably a t-shirt that looks something like this. And, like and subscribe if you made it this far, because that's what you do, you know. And yeah, I'm working on setting up Discord so we can bring people in and chat with the friends on the live stream over on YouTube, BamVFX Art on YouTube. Outside of that, don't forget to be the best you that you can be. Take it easy. Later. I didn't even record. Ugh. Okay. I have to enter or something. Who's fly by? Who's fly by? Alrighty, welcome to ArtCast Companion, where I just kind of go over the last live stream. Last live stream, I kind of zombied out and zoned out. I'm dog tired. And you know why? Because, F you, it's January. So, I made videos about this in the past before, I don't know what it is. January seems to be the month the vampires come out. Those creatures of the night. I'm not talking about the blood-sucking ones. I'm talking about the time ones. Time vampires. Oh my goodness. I always forget about them. And I think that they were in my subconscious back here. Which is why I'm drawing Vampira. And now, as the month is winding down and I'm looking at all these obstacles that get thrown in this one of the coldest months of the year, I'm reminded. It's went from back here and it's drained up to there. It's the time vampires. They just literally suck the creative life force out of you, you know, working overtime, flat tires, dead batteries, catching up on bills from you know the monetary nightmare that is Christmas. you know, it's January is the time for the vampires to come out of the woodwork and just bleed your life force dry. But, you know, this year, I haven't been having it. You know, like, promise myself I'm doing more, because I know there's more I can do. And tonight, after a very stressful day at work, I came home and I started to prep a little bit. You know, I'm pulled open the YouTube, you know, and I saw this 10 dark things you didn't know about the Wizard of Oz, and I was like, well, as I prepare everything and just listen to this thing, and then I could feel it just sucking the life force out of me, and you know, my head tilted, I went slack jawed, and I wasn't doing anything but watching it, and I could just I feel myself getting sucked in, and it was like, yeah, you know, we gotta close this tab, and you know, just prep, get ready, and I was like, okay, well, I don't think I want to do it tonight, and I go, give myself just do 10 minutes, get everything ready. For me, it's open up OBS and Photoshop. If you draw, pull out your sketchbook, line up your pencils, get your pencil sharpener, go through the ritual, and just promise yourself to do 10 minutes worth of work. And I promise you, that is the crucifix of the time vampire. And then, you know, those 10 minutes become 20, become 40, become an hour, become 2 hours. And at least you go to bed that night knowing that you did something. Problem a lot of creative-minded people have is that they're always saying, I'm going to write a book. But they never do anything. They never get to it because you get home after a long day, you're whooped. And, you know, you have dinner, especially after dinner. After dinner, you get the rock gut and you turn on the television or you fire up the old PlayStation or Xbox. You know, and then you just go into, you know, the catatonic zombie state. And then before you know it, it's time for bed. And you wake up, and in the back of your mind, something's nagging at you. You're in a bad mood because you didn't do what the passion is. It requires action. And for your mental state, if you're creative, or if you're working on a project, just give yourself the 10 minutes. With that in mind, though, it's important to, you know, give yourself a break. Give yourself a break as well. But I wouldn't do a break past, you know, 2 or 3 days if you got an itching project to do. I wouldn't even do that because then you start getting into a habit, you know. And, you know, definitely it takes 2 weeks for something to become a habit. You go 2 weeks without doing something, it makes it really hard to get back into it. Anyway, that's just my thought process for today. I appreciate you stopping by. You know where to find me. You can watch me live on BamVFX.com. I paint live on BamVFX Arts. I have a Patreon. We're probably going to have a giveaway of a t-shirt looking a lot like the painting that you're seeing here. So yeah, Patreon, giveaway, t-shirt. We'll be starting to make posters too, so check it out. All the links in the description. Outside of that, don't forget to be the best you that you can be. Take it easy. Later. Later.
Alrighty, welcome to ArtCast Companion, where I just kind of go over the last live stream. Last live stream, I kind of zombied out and zoned out. I'm dog tired. And you know why? Because, F you, it's January. So, I made videos about this in the past before. I don't know what it is. January seems to be the month the vampires come out. Those creatures of the night. I'm not talking about the blood-sucking ones. I'm talking about the time ones. Alrighty. Welcome to ArtCast Companion, where I just kind of go over the last live stream. Last live stream, I kind of zombied out and zoned out. I'm dog tired. And you know why? Because, F you, it's January. So, I made videos about this in the past before. I don't know what it is. January seems to be the month the vampires come out. Those creatures of the night. I'm not talking about the blood sucking ones. I'm talking about the time ones. Time vampires. Oh my goodness. I always forget about them. And I think that they were in my subconscious back here, which is why I'm drawing Vampira. And now, as the month is winding down and I'm looking at all these obstacles that get thrown in this one of the coldest months of the year, I'm reminded. It's went from back here and it's drained up to there. It's the time vampires. They just literally suck the creative life force out of you. You know, working overtime, flat tires, dead batteries, catching up on bills from you know the monetary nightmare that is Christmas. you know it's January is the time for the vampires to come out of the woodwork and just bleed your life force dry. But you know, this year I haven't been having it, you know. Like, promise myself I'm doing more, because I know there's more I can do. And tonight, after a very stressful day at work, I came home and I started to prep a little bit. You know, I'm pulled open the YouTube, you know, and I saw this 10 dark things you didn't know about the Wizard of Oz. And I was like, well, as I prepare everything and just listen to this thing, and then I could feel it just sucking the life force out of me. And you know, my head tilted, I went slack jawed, and I wasn't doing anything but watching it. And I could just feel myself getting sucked in. And it was like, yeah, you know, we gotta close this tab. And you know, just prep, get ready. And I was like, okay, well, I don't think I want to do it tonight. And I go, give myself, just do 10 minutes. Get everything ready. For me, it's open up OBS and Photoshop. If you draw, pull out your sketchbook, line up your pencils, get your pencil sharpener, go through the ritual, and just promise yourself to do 10 minutes worth of work. And I promise you, that is the crucifix of the time vampire. And then you know those 10 minutes become 20, become 40, become an hour, become 2 hours.
And at least you go to bed that night knowing that you did something. Problem a lot of creative minded people have is that they're always saying, I'm gonna write a book. But they never do anything. They never get to it because you get home after a long day, you're whooped, and you have dinner, especially after dinner. After dinner, you get the rot gut and you turn on the television or you fire up the old PlayStation or Xbox. And then you just go into, the catatonic zombie state. And then before you know it, it's time for bed. And you wake up, and in the back of your mind, something's nagging at you. You're in a bad mood because you didn't do what the passion is. It requires action. And for your mental state, if you're creative, or if you're working on a project, just give yourself the 10 minutes. With that in mind, though, it's important to, give yourself a break. Give yourself a break as well. But I wouldn't do a break past, 2 or 3 days if you got an itching project to do. I wouldn't even do that because then you start getting into a habit, And, definitely it takes 2 weeks for something to become a habit. You go 2 weeks without doing something, it makes it really hard to get back into it. Anyway, that's just my thought process for today. I appreciate you stopping by. You know where to find me. You can watch me live on BAMVFX.com. I paint live on BAMVFX Arts. I have a Patreon. We're probably gonna have a giveaway of a t-shirt looking a lot like the painting that you're seeing here. So yeah, Patreon giveaway, t-shirt. Be starting to make posters too, so check it out. All the links in the description. Outside of that, don't forget to be the best you that you can be. Take it easy. Later, later. Take it easy. Later, later. Alrighty, so there you have it. There you have it. Listen, you heard what the man said. Don't forget to be the best you that you can be.